Good morning. My name is William Beauregard McCohen McKenzie Black III, Jr.
You can't believe a word this man says. And I am Ann Sadovsky Sitzman, and we are here to welcome you this morning to Unity of Dallas. Those of you who are watching virtually, and for all of you who are here in the sanctuary today, welcome.
Thank you. I can't tell you how beautiful you all look, how exciting it is to come to a place where we're safe, happy, everybody's kind, everybody's good, and I appreciate each and every one of you all, and the band. And the band. And Miss Carla. We're so fortunate. You ready?
I'm ready. Let's do the opening statement.
There is only one presence and one power active in my life and in the universe. God the good, omnipotent.
Thank you.
We have a new song to sing today, and I know you're going to love it, and I know you're going to find it very easy to sing. So why don't you stand up and let's all sing together. You can stand up at home too if you like. Welcome to love.
Welcome to all of those in here, in person, and those that are virtual. We're so happy you're here. I'm Deb Stovall, and I'm your chaplain for the day. If you would like one-on-one prayer, we are there at the chapel after the church service to be with you. You can also leave a prayer in one of the prayer boxes by the front door. So all of these prayers that we collect are prayed over for a week by one of your chaplains, and then they go to Silent Unity where they're prayed over 24 hours a day for 30 days. So remember Silent Unity and call them if you do need prayer. Let's say our daily word together. Radiance, the Christ presence within is my source of radiant good. Yes. Our source of radiance is within, and we call it our Christ within, or Myrtle calls it her spirit within. Let us pray. As we go within to that Christ place, we think of someone or something we have gratitude for. And when we feel that gratitude, that flowing place of love, we know that we are experiencing our Christ within. We are experiencing the truth of who we are. We are experiencing our spirit. And as we settle into this place within us, we know that God is all around us. God is. God is the energy and the power that created this universe. And we feel that awe-ness now within us as we feel our bodies that function perfectly, every cell knowing every minute exactly what to do. And that is God. We affirm health, abundance, prosperity, financial recovery, all those problems that are out there in that world, and maybe our problems too. And we move our thinking into prosperity thinking, knowing that all is well. All is well because of God's presence. And we know that presence is abundance, as prosperity is divine order. And we feel that now. And we say thank you, thank you, thank you, Father, Mother, God, in the name and power of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Together.
Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel God's mighty power and God's grace. There's a holy hush around us. I see glory.
Everyone. Good morning. My name is Makayla Perkins, and I was born to be standing right here in front of you giving this talk. Yeah. Amen, right? You see, when I practiced giving this talk, I said, I can't believe I'm here. I'm so grateful to be here, which is all true. But today is about standing in your power. It's about opening your eyes to the truth of who you are and exactly what you deserve. And we're starting right now. The talk that I've prepared for you guys today is called Open Your Eyes. And I'm gonna start us off with a story to tell you guys what I mean when I say open your eyes, but also what it might feel like if you choose to open your eyes with me today. So when I was a kid, there's a couple people in the room that can testify to the fact that I was a little stubborn. If I did something wrong, I had a really big problem with apologizing for it, because I was right. My way was the right way. And then one day, my dad took me to the optometrist, and they started doing all these tests like they do, and they told me that I had errored vision. And in my head, I was like, I don't see anything wrong with the way I see the world, but okay. If you think you're right, try to fix it. Go ahead. So they gave me glasses. And like most kids who are in like fourth grade, I did not like the way my glasses looked. But on the way home, my dad was like, knowing, because he wears glasses, he was like, put them on, look around, see how things actually look. So I remember this next part really specifically, probably because I was trying to be dramatic. But I took my glasses out of my case, I closed my eyes, I put them on my face, and I opened my eyes again. And to my surprise, I was genuinely blown away. Now, if you wear glasses, you know exactly what I'm talking about, but if you don't, try to imagine this. I thought trees were green blobs with a brown stick coming out. I thought my kindergarten drawing was accurate. But when I put on those glasses, I could see the leaves, I could see the bark in all their beauty and all their detail. And it was one of those moments where everything and nothing changed at the same time. Nothing changed because the leaves had always been there in all their detail, but everything changed because now I had the chance to see it. I could see the world the way it was supposed to be envisioned. And it was a game changer. That is the feeling we are going for today when we are talking about opening our spiritual eyes. Because when we choose to open our spiritual eyes, your spiritual endowment, your divine nature is no longer something that someone just told you about one Sunday. It's no longer something that you've been trying and trying to convince yourself of and you just can't quite get it. It becomes a part of you. It becomes your best, most genuine trait. It becomes your biggest asset in life. But you have to be able to truly see it. So when I talk to people about opening their eyes, a lot of people ask, well, when did my eyes get shut in the first place? My eyes are open. That's the difference between your spiritual and your physical eyes, but we're gonna talk about it. Here in Unity, we teach something called original blessing. If you came from a traditional background, you may have heard something called original sin, and this is a little bit different. So the definition of this, defined by Danielle Stroller, says that original blessing means that we came into this world far more than just being made in God's image. Original blessing claims that we are steadfastly held lovingly in a relationship with God. Original blessing reminds us that we are good and we are loved before we are anything else. Sin is not in the heart of our nature. Blessing is. So in case you've never heard anything like that before, that is how you came into this world. That is part of the truth of who you are. So you came into this world like that, and for a while you expressed it freely. You danced, you played, no one's judgment really affected you. And then it's a pretty common tale that somewhere along the way you begin to doubt yourself. Maybe someone told you you weren't good enough. Maybe you told yourself that you weren't good enough. But slowly you began to close your eyes to that truth, that core of who you were. But your physical eyes stayed open, and sometimes I wish they didn't, because then we would know when our spiritual eyes had closed, right? But they do, and we go on an autopilot. Maybe you just thought that you were working really hard and didn't have time for rest. But eventually, what happens is you start asking yourself, how did I get here? Something is missing and I don't know what and I don't know how to find it. What is my purpose? What am I supposed to be doing here? Who am I? Those are classic questions and classic frustrations of someone who has closed their spiritual eyes and is being called to open them again. And really, if you want to live the life of your dreams, it's the only way to proceed to open your eyes to the truth of who you are. So, some sermons that I've sat in before, they sell you on this thing and then they don't really tell you how to do it. I could just tell you how great it is to open your eyes, send you on your way, and say good luck. That's how I felt when I was trying to go through this. But I found, at least in my journey, that there's three essential truths that are a good starting point as to what to open our eyes to. So we're going to start with those. The first truth that I have for you guys is this. You are divine. Say, I am divine. Ready? I am divine. There is two responses I get when I tell someone this. The first one is my favorite. The first one is the person who genuinely did not know they were divine. And it is my favorite because I get to tell them that they won the lottery. Yes, you are divine. You are holy. You are whole. You have everything you need within you, and the universe is conspiring to make your dreams happen. Some people are a little skeptical and have questions, but eventually there's this coming home moment where those eyes are opened and you say, yes, I am divine. Now, the second one is the person who thinks they know that they're divine. This one is a good learning opportunity. So most of you in this room have heard before that you are divine. So in your head, somewhere, when I said that you are divine, somewhere in your subconscious, your brain went, oh, I know that. I've heard this before. So my question for you is, do you really know that, though? And I ask you this because of an experience that I recently had. So I took a prosperity class from Reverend Mindy, and it's one of the spiritual education classes on the way of being a minister. And at the beginning of the class, she didn't ask me to do this, but I started writing down my core beliefs about myself. And one of the ones I wrote down is that I am abundant. And then the week went on, I was analyzing my behaviors financially, and I realized that sometimes when I'm stressed, the girl who thinks she's abundant checks her bank account 3 times a day. Is that the behavior of someone who really thinks they're abundant? Call me out. No, it's not. It's not. So to bring this back to divinity, what I'm asking you is if you think you know you're divine, ask yourself, look at some of the things that you've been going through recently, the ways you've reacted, and ask, is this aligned with the belief that I am divine? If your answer is yes, good for you. Keep going. Keep doing it. Let's get that yes more and more and more. If your answer is no, don't be discouraged. Get excited. Because if your answer is no, all that means is that there is more room in your life for divinity. And if you've been studying truth for a while now, you know when you align your life with the truth of who you are, amazing things start happening. So if your answer was no, that means there's more amazing things on its way to be channeled through you and show up in your life. One of the things that I have found in furthering my belief that I am divine is that I don't call miracles miracles anymore. It's not that I don't believe the thing that is the miracle, but the word miracle to me implies that something has happened that's outside of the realm of possibility, outside of the realm or the knowledge of law. But if I am fully grounded in my divine nature, in my divinity, and in divine law, is there anything that is outside the reach of source, of God? No. Everything is possible for you. The recovery of your health, your physical appearance, whatever miracle you're wishing for, can become a part of your everyday life if you are willing to claim that as your truth. Miracles can be your everyday when you align to the fact that you are divine and open those eyes. I know this is a big ask. This is a big truth. But it's one of those fundamental truths that we teach here because if you don't get this one, the other teachings we do don't have their full effect. If you don't believe you're divine, it's really hard to manifest something good if you're in your life if you don't think you deserve it. It's really hard to say those affirmations and mean them if you don't believe them. So take your time with this. Give yourself grace. And know that it's not about, you know, pulling in the divinity. It's just about opening your eyes to it. So the second truth that we're going to move on to is that gratitude is not selective. I didn't go very easy on you guys with these truths, okay? This one's kind of hard to practice, I know. The fact is that most people have a gratitude practice in here. Whether it's a journal that you write five things that you're grateful for every day, or maybe you just make a conscious effort to say thank you for the things that people do for you. This one's about taking your gratitude practice to the next level. And it's not for the faint of heart. So the story that I'm about to tell you has been told to me by many different people. A lot of people have had this show up for them in their life in one way or another. But just for fun, I'm going to tell Oprah's story, because you probably know who she is. So on one of her podcasts, Oprah told this story about how she had had this really bad day. One of those days where everything is crashing in on you and you just don't know how you got to be where you are. So she went home, she sat on the bathroom floor, she was crying, really going through it, and she decided to naturally call her best friend. So she's on the phone with her best friend, she's venting and venting and venting, and she must have talked for like 45 minutes. And her friend listened, lovingly and non-judgmentally. And at the end, Oprah said something like, "I just don't know what to do." And her friend said, "Say thank you." As you can imagine, Oprah was pretty mad because she had a really bad day. She was like, "How dare you say that to me? You're supposed to be there for me. I didn't deserve what happened to me today." Ah. Her friend didn't tell her to say that she deserved what happened to her today. Her friend told her to practice gratitude. Just for the record, saying thank you for a bad situation is not saying that you deserved it. There's a lot of reasons to say thank you even in the darkest of times. You don't have to say thank you for cutting me off, because you're never going to feel that in your heart. Not really, okay? Let's be real. But you can just affirm things that you know to be true. You say thank you because the light and love of God within you shines so brightly that it'll never be put out. You say thank you because your strength runs so deep within you that not only will you go through what's happening, but you will grow and transform from it. You say thank you because you are divine. And you believe that now, because you've opened your eyes to it. There is so much to say thank you for. Even if the only thing you can think of when someone has kind of, you know, done something that's not right is, thank you for being part of my journey. It's not about saying it to them, it's for you. Have gratitude for yourself, because you're the one you're healing with gratitude, not necessarily them. So the next truth, our final truth for today, life works from the inside out, not from the outside in. We live in a world that makes money selling us external solutions for internal problems. And the issue with that is that we grow up with this tendency to focus more on what's going on outside of us than what's happening within us. The issue with that is that the power is not out there. The power is in here. A very popular writer in Unity, his name is Eric Butterworth, and he will tell you that oftentimes it's not about setting something right out there, it's about seeing something right. Right here. And what he means by that is because whatever's going on within us, it affects all of us. It affects our perception. It affects our mental health, our emotions. It affects the energy you put out into the world, which in turn affects the people that you attract into your life. What's going on in here isn't just in here, it's everywhere. So when we choose to stop pointing the finger at other people and ask yourself the question, what could this really be about? What is really bothering me in this moment? We draw awareness to what's going on in here, to the hurt that might have happened in here. But you can't just draw attention to one part of who you are. You draw attention to all of it. So when you acknowledge the part of you that's hurt, you're also acknowledging the part of you that is divine. You're acknowledging the part of you that deserves to have that hurt amended. And as we talked about earlier, you know, you are divine, but really the only thing that separates the fact that I'm divine and you're divine, or so-and-so is divine, is the level of awareness you have of that divinity. That's why some people act the way they do, is because it's not because they're not divine. It's not because we're not all in the same playing field. It's because they're not quite as aware of that yet. So when you choose to use your awareness, use that power, and turn within, you are more likely to act in the truth of who you are. You are less likely to say, bleep you, and say, thank you. You are more likely to act in a way that you will be proud of. And you'll see that it works. You will see that it works when you work on the stuff inside and start looking at what happens in your life on the outside of you. So let's take a breath. You are divine. Gratitude is not selective. And life works from the inside out. The way I want to end my talk today is something that's extremely special to my heart. If you guys have heard my story with Unity, you know that I grew up on these principles. It shaped who I am. And I got the privilege of going through the youth program and traveling all over the US, spreading these principles, teaching them to kids in high school. And one of the traditions that we have with these events is something called an angel wash. This is a picture from a couple years ago. That's me, a couple years younger, sitting in that chair up there. And it's a really beautiful process where the person sitting in my chair, right there, has two rows of people lining them. And the person in the chair gets prayed in by a leader. And then when they're done, they stand up, they close their eyes, and the people on both sides also stand. They are then passed from each person, and each person hugs them, and while they are hugging them, in their ear, they say truth. They wash them with love. They tell them the things they most appreciate about their soul and the impact that they have personally had on their lives. Most of these kids have grown up together through yay high all the way to high school. It's an extremely moving, tearful thing to have, what, 10 other people affirm to you the truth of who you are. If I had time to angel wash every last one of you today, I would absolutely do it. But I'm pretty sure that James has some psychic power, and I think he would know that I went over time and I'd be in trouble. So we're not gonna go with that today. But what I am going to do is I'm gonna angel wash you all at once. From the deepest part of my heart, I am going to affirm to you the truth and the love that you are. So if you are ready to receive this blessing, I want you to put your hands together, rub them, get some energy going, open them up, open your heart, and close your eyes. As you take a deep breath in and out, allow your heart to open, your physical eyes to lay heavily shut. Letting the stories that you've told yourself wash away. Anything you think you know, lay to rest. Here, in this moment, is the only place that you need to be. Take my words as your own, letting them paint a new picture of who you are and what you deserve. You are perfect. There is not a single part about you that is not in line with the love and the light that you are. Every step you take, every breath that you breathe on this earth, not only adds to the strength and the love that you are, but you radiate it out to every single person that you encounter. You are so strong. You have triumphed through so much. And your strength is an inspiration. You are enough. Any feeling of lack that you have ever experienced has been an illusion. And if that illusion hurt you, I am so sorry. But guess what? It's not you. In this moment now, you are free of every limiting story that you have ever told yourself, because you are divine. You are powerful. You are kind. You are selfless. And I am honored to be in your presence. Take a deep breath in. Take a moment of gratitude for your body. It has carried you through so much. Take a moment of gratitude for your mind. It allows you to consciously grow and expand every day. Take a moment of gratitude for your soul. It fills you. It makes life whole and meaningful. Let a smile creep onto your face, because you have so much to be grateful for. And when you are ready, I invite you to open both your physical and your spiritual eyes. I will leave you with this. In case you didn't know, you should be on the first thing, you should be the first thing on your gratitude list. Not the last, and not on there, especially. Oh my gosh. You are powerful, you are beautiful, and you are divine, and I am honored that you picked today with me to open your eyes. Thank you.
A well-deserved standing ovation. How old are you, Makayla?
I'm 20.
When I was 20, I could hardly find my way home. So thank you for the path that you are on and for the wisdom that comes from this beautiful young woman. She's speaking again next Sunday to complete these thoughts. I know that you will sail out of here today with your eyes wide open. So thank you again, Makayla.
Thank you.
You have to be busting your buttons. The family is her support group is here today, and we're so glad you're here. So just a reminder that this is the time that we talk about offering and your tithes for Unity of Dallas. We have several ways that you can give. We have a donation station right out. We used to call it the box, and thank goodness Makayla named it the donation station. Makes a little bit more sense, okay? Right out in the hallway if you want to drop in a check or cash. If you do cash, please put it in an envelope with your name on it. You can text GIVE. It's on your screen. It's on the website. There's a mobile app, GIVE, the website, donate tab, and, of course, the post office. You can mail it to the church at 6525 25 Forest Lane, Dallas 75231. So with all of that, let's bless our offerings and let's take into heart exactly what Makayla had to say today. Beauregard, come on, come here with me, okay? So I'll just ask that with this wonderful lesson today from this beautiful young soul, that we take to heart and know that in so many ways we support Unity of Dallas. So let's say together our offertory blessing. Divine love as me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, Spirit.
Wonderful week.
Wow.
This is a blessing. blessing. You all are blessings. We're all blessings, and we're, again, so darn lucky.
We're so lucky to be in a community where we have this kind of support.
Look
and that we
everybody.
Get to, you
You're
know, reveal all the beautiful talents that each and every one of us have.
Yeah.
All of us have talents.
The band.
Aren't they terrific?
The band. Yep. So we have a few Zoom opportunities, and we have some exciting things coming up.
We certainly do. Today is the end of the book sale. And all the books are out front, half price or 45% off, and then they're going to redo the whole book nook. Then, the 15th of August, this is exciting, David Freeman returns. You know him as a composer and as a singer, but he's also a writer and a public speaker. David will teach us in ways we can hold life's challenges. It's a lecture, but it's a song that he did from it. I'm sorry. Help is on his way. You'll like this better. It is a lecture that he will do after the sermon, but it comes from one of his songs.
So you may remember David from We Can Be Kind. Most of us bought the book. He was here. The song became famous. And he is a Broadway producer. So this is a big talent.
And a Tony winner. If you don't know what that is, that's the Oscar for movies, but these are Broadway shows. He has a Tony. He's in demand, and he wants to be here.
Isn't that exciting? Yes. And if you will schedule yourselves, he's doing a thought exchange workshop where you can bring your issues, if you have any of them, and learn how to hold them with the thought, help is on the way. I love the way he worded that. So many thousands of people have attended that workshop. So on that same day, he will be doing the workshop in the afternoon. There's a $25 love offering for that. So real quickly, we have the camp out coming up October 1st through 4th. Will you be going?
We'll see.
That's because camping out for me and Beau is a cheap Holiday Inn. That's camping out. Okay.
It only costs $5 a day for you to get in the park. There are tents available, but again, you can rent a cabin if you like.
Okay. And then Sea Week is coming up in November. For those of you who are not familiar, it's a week long with different speakers, different amazing classes for you to learn more and more about unity and unity principles and about yourself and about how we live. So, and Reverend James will be doing a talk during that. Soupmobile, $5 cash for McDonald gift cards out front, a place to drop that in so that people can dine with dignity. We do that for people who are homeless and in need. And we also have a new drop box for transportation donations for our elders and for people who no longer drive who need a ride to church. So if you'd like to drop a couple of bucks in there also, that would do.
We will get you here. Let us know, okay?
Yes, that we will. So I think with all of that, since James is away, the mice will play. James doesn't like for us to bring paper up here today, but we decided last minute to do this together. So I think that we have done everything we need to do. So let there be peace on earth.
Let's sing the peace song. Sing it like you mean it, friends.
as we go our way today, we take this precious young woman's words to heart. We walk out of here with our eyes wide open. Let the church say together, Amen. Amen.